thanks for pulling over.
Sure. Something wrong?
We got a problem up ahead. A big accident. We've had to close the road.
You're right.
We're diverting all traffic through Little Hope. You okay, buddy? You seem a little confused.
Yeah, I'm fine. I just want to get these folks to where they need to be.
I doubt a short delay will trouble them too much. Head up the East Road. Takes you straight through Little Hope. Adds almost no time to your journey.
Chip any harder, it'll wear away to nothing. How long have you been sober?
A few days shy of 3 months.
Impressive. I heard the first 90 days are the toughest and roughest.
I know it doesn't add up, but I get something from holding on to this.
We're going the wrong way.
It's fine, just a quick detour.
It's not fine.
Calm down. It's all okay.
Oh, please, John, could you not patronize me?
Can you keep it down, please?
Stop it, James. You know I hate it when you don't take the things I say seriously.
Come on, sweetheart, I do. I just had a rough day today.
Can you believe they are at each other again? I can.
You're drunk. What a surprise.
I just caught the game with the guys, honey. That's it.
That's not it. Never is.
There's talk. Some of us may be losing our jobs. The factory...
You've been saying that for years. I'm more worried about Megan.
What's wrong with Megan? She looks okay to me.
Everything looks okay after 10 beers. Reverend Carson held her back after prayers today. That's 4 weeks running. She's not right. It's serious, James.
You worry too much about that kid. I can't deal with this right now.
Another surprise. You can't deal with anything. When would be the right time?
You're making a mountain out of a molehill. Getting yourself worked up for nothing.
For nothing? Single-handedly keeping our family together is far from nothing in my book. I could use a little help.
Maybe if we'd had kids of our own, none of this would be happening.
That's a real low blow. Don't you get how tough this is?
You're not the only one feels pressure. The factory situation is serious, Anne. Real serious. Not right now.
Not tonight. No way.
Tanya's late. She always is these days.
At least one of us is out having a good time. Give her a break.
It's him I'm worried about. That guy's no good for her. All that New Age bullshit. Reminds me of some creepy cult.
He came in last week. We shot the breeze a little bit. I like him.
That one's a classic. Legendary vinyl. Quit pawing at it, will you? Hey, Bigfoot, mind the goddamn vinyl, will ya?
no need to be so tough on her. It was an accident.
Everything Megan does is an accident.
I'm going to start climbing through the window unless that door gets fixed. How's things? Let me guess. He's been pumping iron again?
They've been at each other's throats since Dad got home.
What's it about this time?
Dad's been drinking. Who could have guessed it?
They're always fighting these days, getting predictable. Like a record that keeps playing over and over.
Dennis, for the 10 millionth time, will you shift that shit of yours up into the attic?
Hey, some respect. This is a valuable, rare, and sought-after collection. I think she was a Marine sergeant in a past life.
What's crawled up his ass?
Just Dennis doing what he's good at. Being really Dennis.
A surprise.
Hey, Dennis. Hey!
Not now, sis. I'm busy. Crazy!
Oh! Jesus! You scared me, sweetheart.
I heard you talking about me.
Not now, Megan. I'd like to have a bath in peace. Take a break from this madhouse for a while.
Should talk to Mom and Dad.
It's not a great idea for me to get involved. You know what I'm like? I just upset someone.
This sounded more serious than the usual bullshit. They were talking about Megan. She's done something bad.
I can't say I'm surprised. There's definitely something off with Megan.
I don't get why everyone keeps picking on her.
Okay, Mr. Shining Knight in Armor. Where's the little princess anyway?
Probably better to leave Megan alone.
As her big sister, it is my sworn legal duty to check in on her.
Right, sure. Like you're the law around here. She went upstairs.
I'll go find her.
Keep an eye on your little sister. Mom is real worried about her.
It's okay, Dad. Tanya's checking on her right now.
You want to try raising a family like this? The devil himself would struggle with you guys.
Hey, Tanya. You up there? How's Megan doing?
Don't know. Haven't seen her yet.
Keep it down, will ya? Trying to sleep here.
Now you've done it. Sleeping Beauty wakes.
Forget him. Find Megan.
Relax. I'm on it.
Do me a favor. Quit yelling for a couple of minutes. House could use some quiet.
Sure, no problem. Not another sound.
Place is crazy enough without your 2 cents. It's all the noise about, anyway.
Just checking in with Tanya and Megan.
Good luck with that. Megan's a handful.
Anthony, where are you, goddammit? Anthony, I'm getting really pissed off! Anthony, I swear if you don't answer me!
You could be right about my family. I think so too.
Tanya, what's going on?
That little brat locked me out. It's fucking freezing!
I'll let you back in. Go easy on Megan. Hold on. Shit! Megan! You in there? The kitchen's on fire!
Are you fucking serious?
Megan!
Breathe! drain pipe and climb down.
Won't you spare me over till another
welcome back. I have a new story for you. It's very different to the last. Disconcerting, no? I'm sure there's nothing to worry about. This particular story isn't fully fleshed out. It's only part written, and the choices you make will complete it. The fire, no, there was nothing you could have done about that. What's happened has happened. Or has it? Anyway, look to the future, I say. Life's but a walking shadow, eh? You are about to enter a confusing, perhaps disturbing world. How disturbing might depend on what you choose to believe, and how confusing on the path you choose to take. There are an infinite number of directions in which one could travel. We seldom have all the information that we'd like, but we have to choose our path nonetheless and hope that we get the clarity and the outcomes that we want. As in life, your decisions will matter. The choices you make will affect others. You've seen how the story starts. So much death. How many more deaths is entirely up to you. It depends on the decisions that you make. What are you? Rational? Emotional? Do you trust your head or your heart? There is no right answer. Sometimes one is best and sometimes the other. My advice, for what it's worth, is to thine own self be true. But I'm here simply to record what you do, not to help you. I'm not supposed to interfere, you see. Not my place, apparently. But I am apparently allowed to share wise words from great storytellers that have gone before, where I feel that that would be appropriate. Oh, one final thing before I let you go. There are pictures in Little Hope that will, if found, show you a vision of a possible future, something that may or may not happen. Use them. They might help you. You have a funeral to attend. Off you go. Have fun. I do enjoy a good funeral.
None of us here today can understand why this tragic accident happened. But we can take comfort from the knowledge that the family are together for eternity in God's loving embrace.
Where the hell's Daniel? I can't find him.
I don't know.
Ah!
Instead of goofing around, you want to lend a hand here?
How is he doing anyway?
It doesn't look that serious. Could be concussed.
Okay, Professor. Or should I call you Doctor now?
Why don't you try calling for help? Maybe the cops, someone like that.
I already tried once, but I'm on it.
Hey, Andrew, buddy, how you doing?
Where are we? What happened?
Yeah, the bus crashed. We're okay, though, just shaken up.
If you say so. I don't remember being in any crash.
You're probably in shock. Maybe a mild concussion in there, too. Give yourself some time. Stay here. Don't move.
well be dead.
Okay, take it easy. We'll figure out what to do.
Fuck. Where's my phone? Hey, anyone up there?
Hey, Daniel, that you?
John, good to hear you.
Daniel?
Taylor, you okay?
I'm good.
We're fine too, thanks for asking. You okay down there?
I'm all right, nothing I can't deal with.
Hey, John, any idea what caused the crash?
Not sure. Looked like the driver swerved to avoid something in the road. He down there, by the way?
Nope. No sign of him.
Weird. He isn't up here either. Can you get back up to us?
Looks pretty steep. I see a trail down here I could try.
Great. Take the trail. Should take you to the road. We can regroup there.
That's a plan. See you soon.
Hey, Taylor. Help me get Andrew up on his feet, will ya?
Wait. I don't remember anything. Who are you?
It's okay. You're concussed. I'm John, you're a college professor. We were taking a bus on a field trip, but that didn't work out so well. Crash wasn't on the curriculum. We'll find the others, get some help. Think of it as a character building exercise. Teamwork at its finest.
I had this dream. It was so real. Flames all around us. It was grim.
That bang on the head must have been a beauty.
That trail the others are on will come out down the road. We'll meet them there.
We should talk this through. Why leave the bus? Not like we have somewhere better to wait.
No. We could be here all night. Our best move is to get to the others, then head towards town. See if we can find some help.
Where's the driver? Shouldn't he be back by now?
The driver's done what we should be doing. Gone into town for help.
You're right. Let's go. I'm with you.
I'm right?
The quicker we get help, the quicker we can all go home.
Stick close behind me.
Can't believe the driver. Taking off like that and ditching us?
Maybe he didn't realize. Could just be in shock.
We're his responsibility, his passengers. He can't just stroll off. You know this place? Little Hope?
No. I mean, I don't think so.
You should both know Little Hope.
Why should I have heard of this place?
Seriously, this place is steeped in history. Fascinating stuff. History for you two is remembering the last burger you ate. Good to see you two, finally. Everything okay?
Sure. We took the scenic route.
You sure as hell took your own sweet time. I was getting worried.
I bet you were.
This gate is chained. We can't get through.
Look around. See if there's anything we can use to break it.
Think this'll do it?
Ready? I'll push hard from my side.
Ready. 3, 2, 1, push!
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about!
Great job, you two.
What's the plan now?
Head into town, see if we can get help.
You know where town is?
Sure, we're near Little Hope.
Sounds like a fun place.
Funnily enough, Little Hope does have an interesting and dark history.
Can we get going without having a smart-ass lecture first?
I'm starting not to like you or your attitude.
I'm not even started yet. You want a little more?
Try to be civil. Cost nothing.
That's rich, given how you badmouthed Taylor on the way over.
What did she say about me?
You always get your boyfriend to stick up for you? Try doing it yourself sometime, dear.
I'm not wasting another breath on you.
Quit it, will you? The last thing we need is you causing trouble.
Keep out of our business, okay?
We are wasting valuable time here. Can we please just keep moving?
You think this is a solid plan, heading into town?
As good as any.
I went along with it before, but I'm not so sure now.
So what do you want to do?
How about you come with me back to the bus?
Okay.
I still think the smart move is for us all to stick together.
You'd be glad we didn't stick together after we flagged down a car and come rescue your ass.
You get lost?
No.
We're back here?
This doesn't add up. This is some very weird shit going on here.
Spare us all. First he loses his pride, then he loses his way.
What are you trying to say?
That you've lost it.
It's not possible.
Look, I don't know what you're trying to prove here, but we've got better things to do.
Daniel?
Whoa!
Hey, careful!
Watch out!
Quit fucking around and tell me what's going on here.
The two of us will go together.
This is getting ridiculous.
Indulge me. Right. We walked dead straight going away from you. So, how'd we end up back here?
Okay, let's try something. We'll all go together. We came from that direction. We must be able to go back that way. I want everyone to stay real close. No stragglers.
You want to put us on a kid's line? Okay, okay, I'm coming. I admit, that is a little odd.
More than a little.
See? What did I tell you?
It's just like I've been saying, we are trapped! We can't leave here! Now
okay.
What do we do?
Calm down, breathe. There's a rational explanation for what's happening.
Maybe we all died in the crash.
Yeah, nice theory, but I'm pretty sure we're all still alive and kicking.
Last I checked, you were schooling us on creative writing, not metaphysics.
I know who I'd like to be kicking. This is all down to you, this pissy little field trip. Now we're stuck here in Little No Hope.
That is way out of line. I had no way of knowing that damn bus would crash. You can't put that on me.
Are you for fucking real?
Watch your tone, will you? I am doing my best to understand this, just like you and the rest of us.
Sorry. I don't get what's happening to us. I don't understand.
It's like you said, we're trapped in a nightmare.
It's okay. We're gonna be just fine. We'll figure a way out of this together.
Someone else thinks they can do a better job? Step right up.
Maybe it isn't real.
We have to get out of here right
now. I need to think straight.
Now.
Football coaching.
Why the fuck?
Can everyone just shut up?
This isn't helping us find help or getting us out of here.
He's right. Bitching at each other isn't getting us anywhere. We have to work together as a team.
Thank you.
Now let's be logical. The fog is between us and the bus. There is no fog between us and town, so let's head that way.
I don't get how heading further away from the bus helps.
There is nothing on the bus we can use to get help. In town, there will be people, a working phone, something.
It pains me to admit, but he's right. There's nowhere else we can go except into that damn town.
Sounds like a plan to me.
You leaving me? Where are you going?
Come on, let's go with them. Until we know what's up, we should stick together.
Why did you say we might all be dead? You really think that's possible?
I saw some cable show about how your brain keeps going for a while after you... You know.
You die?
Forget about it. What they said didn't really stack up.
I don't like the look of that place at all.
Maybe they won't ask for ID.
I'm not sure this is such a great idea.
We should check it out. There could be a phone inside.
I'll go in and take a look around.
Go ahead. We'll be right behind you.
Why aren't we going with those guys?
Angela knows there's something between us. That's obvious.
We're really going to get into this now? Like we've got no other bigger shit to deal with tonight?
This is a big deal. For me, anyhow. I'm telling you, Angela is onto us. She knows.
What did you two talk about?
She was digging around like she always does.
What exactly did you tell her back there?
Relax. I said nothing about us.
I'm not ready to go public about us yet. I will be soon, I promise.
Anything I can do to help convince you I'm the right guy?
I need to know 100% I can rely on you. That you'll never let me down.
We should catch up with the others.
We standing here all night, or we going inside?